Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We will begin the boarding process at this time. Please proceed to your concert seats immediately. If anything or anyone looks suspicious, please notify Captain Rader or First Officer Lane Nazette. Final checks are being completed, and the captain will order the doors of the theater to close in approximately 5 minutes' time. Once on board, please remain in your seat and give your full attention to the front of the plane. Bright lights and loud sounds will occur throughout the flight. However, that is completely normal for the operation of this aircraft. Celebrate music inspired by flight. Federal regulations require that passengers be seated before closing the theater doors. Items such as coats, handbags, or flowers must be kept out of the aisles. Cellular devices should be turned to airplane mode, silenced, or turned off and stowed in your handbag or completely under your seat. Use caution if needing to leave the theater during the program. Please do so only during student movements between the bands. Throughout the flight, please let our flight attendants know how they may assist you. We apologize, but we will not be serving a light snack or any beverages during this flight. In fact, there's no food or beverages of any type allowed on this aircraft. Please dispose of any snacks outside the theater. Even with no food, we do promise lots of in-flight entertainment. In order to expedite our departure, please be seated as quickly as possible. Once again, thank you for joining us. We'll be on our way shortly. Thank you. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Captain Raider from the flight deck. Welcome aboard Flight 040424, the service to Bandland. Thank you for your attention while we review some of the important information for tonight's program. In preparation for departure, please be certain that personal belongings are out of the aisles and either in your lap or placed completely under your seat. Take a moment, make sure that your cell devices are silenced or turned off, as calls, texting, and gaming are not approved during the program. You may use devices for taking photos or videos, but for everyone's enjoyment, please use these sparingly. We're next for takeoff, so that we ask that you're in your full and upright position. Take a moment to review the theater exit doors, and remember, your closest exit may be behind you. If there's a loss of electrical power, emergency lights will come on to illuminate the auditorium, and we hope we won't need oxygen masks because they will not drop from overhead, so please exit to the outdoors. In the unlikely event of an emergency landing and evacuation, please leave your items behind and proceed orderly outside. There will be no emergency slides or life rafts, just watch the stairs. And on behalf of our directors and student musicians, it's our pleasure to have you aboard, and as is the tradition here at SFS, please join us in a word of prayer before we depart. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for the opportunity to come together and celebrate this time, these students, all the preparations that they put in their musical endeavors. We ask that you bless them, bless their experience here on the stage and our experience as audience members. In Jesus' name, amen. With that, we ask you to sit back, relax, and enjoy your flight to Bandland.
Thank you. welcome everybody. Thank you for coming to our spring concert. My name is Joshua Yenu and I'm one of the band directors here at Seoul Foreign School. It sure is great to see you tonight. You've just been listening to the High School Jazz Band. Let's give it up for the High School Jazz Band. And that was Come Fly With Me, made popular by Frank Sinatra in the 50s. It featured an alto solo by Jusong Park and Justin Kang on the trumpet. So, Come Fly With Me. Where do you want to go? Well, how about Paris? Well, what month is it? It's April. April in Paris. That's a great idea. So, this next song, April in Paris, did you like how I connected to the theme there? April in Paris was originally written for a Broadway musical in the 30s, but Count Basie made it popular in the 50s, and our arrangement tonight is very similar to the original, and it will feature Ethan Chun on the trombone, and Yoon Jae Jin on the trumpet, and a few drum fills as well by Christine. So we hope you enjoy our version of April in Paris. Shall we do it again? All right, one more time. Thank you. That was April in Paris. How was that ending? Justin Kang on those screamers. Good work, everybody. Okay, so come fly with me. Let's go to Paris. Who's going to be in that romantic city? How about just the two of us? Mia, this one's for you. All right. This lovely arrangement, but it'll be the three of us, and that's okay. Our child. The lovely arrangement, Justin Kang actually found this one. So thank you, Justin. A lot of the members of the jazz band find charts they want to play, and they give it to me. This is not me being a fuddy-duddy and playing music from the 80s, even though I was born before the 80s. They like this music. So he went and found an arrangement. I said, what a great arrangement, let's play it. So just the two of us, originally a hit by Grover Washington Jr. This will feature solos by Kyung Chung on tenor saxophone, Ethan Chan on trombone, Jusong Park. Jusong, you're working hard tonight. Lots of solos. We'll pay you double. How does that sound? Very good. All right, Jusong Park and Amin Eliadase on tuba. Bless you all. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for being such a great audience. And of course, the two drummers, Christine Chung and Schaefer Won, blessing us with their rhythms this evening. Good work, guys. Give it up for them. Thank you. So we're going to close out our set with you with Fly Me to the Moon, our beautiful Sammy Nestico arrangement. And this will feature Jusong on alto, hardest working man in show business right there, ladies and gentlemen. And Jusong, we'll do an alto solo. And this piece is quite bittersweet. It's our last performance of the year for the jazz band. And in fact, there are some seniors who will be leaving us, Juancho Agravante and Christine Chan, the drummer. And we'll recognize them when we recognize the seniors. But guys, thank you for your work. We are going to miss you. So thank you for being such a great audience. This is Fly Me to the Moon.
Hello from the flight deck. This is your captain speaking. We've reached a cruising altitude at approximately 144 beats per minute. I have momentarily turned off the fasten seatbelt sign. If you need to stand up and stretch, next portion of the flight will begin in just a few minutes. Thank you. flight attendants, cabin crew, passengers, please return to your seats. Crusader Band performance is about to begin.
My name is Sophie Holbrook, and I am Mr. Yanu's co-pilot to go along with the theme tonight. Thank you for letting us have some fun with you as we've come up with this program to celebrate their music with tied around the theme of flight. We're going to get started with Fanfare for Flight, written by a new composer. He's very young. He was born in the year 2000. And so this is just the beginning of his composing career, but Adrian Sims has written a couple gems already. This is one of them. This was selected as one of the pieces for the recent APAC band trip that we took in February to Kobe, Japan. There are several students who took part in that trip. You can see all of that in the program on the back with the student names. This piece specifically talks about flight. It's very energetic. Lots of technical passages that the students play to have that feeling of taking off. So we hope you enjoy Adrian Sims' Fanfare for Flight.
Thank you.
Thank you, co-pilot. So yes, this Crusader band is co-piloted by Sophie Holbrook and myself, equal partnership, along with two other bands in the middle school, the symphonic band and the concert band. And it's wonderful to see the transition of the students all the way through and work together on those three bands. So how are you going this evening? You enjoying the music so far? These kids have been working hard for the last 6 months, actually, to put on this show. And we came up with this theme of flight, Sophie and I, around November or December, I think it was. And it just took off. Yeah. Anyway, I think I'll stick to music. All right. So this next piece really directly relates to the theme. It's called Metamorphosis, and it's about the life cycle of a butterfly. And when it changes from a caterpillar to learning how to fly and flying off into the distance when it's a butterfly. And the composer writes that when he was composing this tune, he couldn't help but think that it's similar to our lives when we start off as children and develop through adolescence and our lives finally take flight. There's a moment of flight that happens. And so I would like to dedicate this piece to all of the musicians in the high school band program. I pray that you find your calling and your lives begin to take flight. So this is Metamorphosis. Thank you. Thank you. The next song is called Rainbow in the Clouds. And in the Bible, the rainbow is a symbol of God's promise to us. And this piece is based on a 19th century African-American spiritual. And the words go, "When I looked like the sun wouldn't shine no more, God put a rainbow in the clouds." And tonight, if you're going through a hard time, I hope this song brings comfort to you, knowing that hope and deliverance will come. And maybe, just maybe, you need to be the rainbow in someone else's clouds. So whatever that may be, I pray this song would bless you. Rainbow in the Clouds. And this is featuring the euphonium player Eugenie Wang and flute player Jane Chang. Give it up for them.
As the percussion is getting set up, I'm going to tell you just a little bit about this next piece. You'll see in your program that it says excerpts from The Firebird. The Firebird is originally a ballet written by Igor Stravinsky in 1910 for the Paris Opera. Now, when you write music for ballet, you're telling a story, and you're going to hear several of those storylines presented through the music. I'm not going to tell you all of the themes because it would take so long to do, but I really encourage you to look up The Firebird later when you get a chance, because it's a really beautiful story. And at the end, we have the glorious firebird that the character turns into. You're going to hear several soloists throughout the band, and they'll be at the end, they'll be standing up, so you can applaud them then. Stravinsky, as a composer, he studied with Nikola Rimsky-Korsakov, who is another Russian composer as well. And under his tutelage, he was writing for ballets, a lot of them at the same time. So after the 1910 Firebird, he then wrote Petrushka in 1911, and then The Rite of Spring, which is probably the most famous of the three, in 1913. Those ballets, as popular as they were, they had a big kind of experience at the beginning because no one had heard music like this at the time. A lot of chromaticism, a lot of notes that were deemed not very pretty, and that was on purpose. That's in the music, and it tells a story for that reason. However, at the time, people were appalled that music could sound like that. So in The Rite of Spring, actually, in the premiere, people were throwing tomatoes and storming out of the theater. Please don't do that. Okay, but the point is, this music is different, and I think it's very beautiful. There are some really lush harmonies, as well as the loud bits that you'll experience as well. Although we're not doing a ballet, I did ask Mr. Yanu if he wanted to dance for us, but his tights are at home. But next time, maybe. There are concert productions of these three works, the three that I mentioned, Petrushka and Rite of Spring, and then this one, The Firebird. So it's done regularly with orchestras, and this is now a band arrangement. The original ballet is 45 minutes long. This is boiled down to about 4, 5, 6 minutes, maybe. Okay, so these are just the excerpts. Please enjoy Stravinsky's The Firebird.
Thank you.
Hello again from up front. On behalf of our entire crew, we do hope that you are enjoying your travel with us today. We will begin our descent shortly, and as we enter this last phase of the flight, we ask that you remain in your full and upright position with open ears and devices away. Thank you for flying with us today, and safe travels in the future.
Thank you. So this is the wind ensemble of the high school. It's the highest level of band we offer here at Soul Foreign, and students needed to work hard and audition and convince me they were good enough to get in. And I think they sound fabulous tonight. Give it up for them one more time. Wind Ensemble, we love you. So some students in this band have done three honor bands, the APAC band, the National Honor Band, and we'll head off to Hong Kong for the Army Asian Honor Band next week. And they've prepared this program as well. So each program has about 5 or 6 pieces of music in it. So they've learned around 20, 25 pieces of music. So they have been so busy, and you'll see them honored on the program. But the second half of the year is hugely busy compared to the first half. So that's great. This next piece is called Catcher and Corral. And this piece is written, and it's connected to the theme of flight, when the human heart takes flight after those things which are lesser than it should. And the composer wrote it with that thought in mind. It's about the emptiness of materialism. And Clifton Williams is a prominent wind band composer, and he wrote this when he had cancer. And he actually died shortly after. This is the last piece that he wrote. And the first part of this is depicting that chase that I know has happened to me. You chase after things that are less than what you should, and it makes you feel empty, and you'll hear a lot of dissonance. It's reflected in the harmony. But then the second movement is a chorale. It's a call to bring us back to our spiritual selves, our center, to become more centered in worthwhile things, to turn from materialism to worthwhile things. So this piece has a very prominent message, and Catcher and Corral.
Thank you.
At this stage, I'd like to welcome all of the seniors in the high school band program to please come to the stage. Please welcome them as they come. Sorry, I have my back to you. I need to talk to them. Seniors, I want to thank you for continuing in the band program through your time here at SFS. Your leadership has been amazing. You inspire younger players, and the experience you bring to every ensemble is invaluable. I hope being in band has taught you a few things about life, like how to shape your life into something beautiful through discipline and hard work, how to work well with others and be part of a team, how to negotiate with others, like when you have to tune and you're both wrong until you're both right, how to find your voice and express freely, and how to express when you don't feel like it, but the music's telling you you have to. You guys have been amazing. And how to push yourself to the limits of what you're capable of doing when you put your mind to it. Mrs. Holbrook and I have enjoyed watching you grow up in Bandland. That's where we all are tonight, in Bandland. And we're gonna miss seeing you here next year. So thank you for your dedication. Thank you for your hard work. You guys are amazing. So from, who was in Mrs. Holbrook's grade 5 beginner band? Some of you were? Fantastic. And none of you were in the grade 6 beginner band with me, were you? No, good. All right, that's next year. But listen, this has been your home and your family. I pray that you'll continue to love music and to find it as a passion in your life. We're going to give you a rose, and I pray that God would help you find your way and follow your passion and help you become who you're meant to be. And so, seniors, I'm going to dedicate this next song to you. This piece is about love, and it's the love that happens when you find your passion in life. It's called Halcyon Hearts, written very recently, and pray you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to finish off with a medley of themes composed by the amazing composer John Williams. And it's all the themes that have captured the wonder and the fantasy of flight for the many movies he's composed for. I want to give a special shout out to John Black and Crusader Live for what you're about to see. But I want to thank you again for being a wonderful audience, and I'm looking forward to meeting you in the foyer. Stick around and say hi if you can. We love you all. Be blessed, and thank you.
On behalf of SFS Airlines and the entire crew, I'd like to thank you for joining us on this trip, and we are looking forward to seeing you on board again in the near future. Our next flight is scheduled for takeoff tomorrow at 6 p.m. featuring the choir and orchestra fleet. But before we deplane, we'd like to thank all our frequent flyers, and particularly our crew captains for today, Mr. Josh Yanu and Ms. Sophie Holbrook, for their service throughout the flight. You're free to go. Thank you.